Hey everybody, welcome back to Northern Lion Plays The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. I lost my streak, sort of. I played with Nick. We had a streak of like 3 on the stream, and I was like, 3, no problem. He picks Eden, I give him the seed, and I die because the Eden run was terrible. Let's just have some fun, shall we? Don't do it! Okay, Lazarus, didn't we? Like, our last run actually on video was Lazarus? I can't remember. It doesn't matter, Lazarus is probably my second least favorite character in the game. Here's the seed on screen, by the way. Of course, I'm exempting the Lost from this. Why do I dislike Lazarus? He's just got nothing really going for him, except for that Lazarus's Rags starting item, and Lazarus's Rags is like, who cares, basically, is where I'm gonna go with that one. I apologize for struggling to find my words. I was trying to be polite, as is the, you know, the innate Canadian way. Don't buy that, by the way. There's a lot of impolite Canadians, you know? We're very polite to tourists, but then as soon as, you know, they turn their back, we go, oh, fucking Americans. Can't find their way to our La Banquise. That was a bit more of a francophone, but I have a French descent, so I can say it. Anyway. This is okay. We don't actually do that, by the way. In fact, Canadian politeness can sometimes be a bad thing, though. One time, I was still in college, and I grew up in the town that I went to college in, but this truck, like, stopped as it was driving and was like, hey, like, where do I get to Montana's? It's like a barbecue restaurant. A big barbecue restaurant. It's a chain. And I, like, thought about it for a second, and I was like, I know where Montana's is. I know where I am. I'll just point in the direction that they go. And then I pointed, and I was like, yeah, just keep going that way. You'll find it in, like, 30 minutes. Because this is, you know, a sprawling town, sort of. They were like, thanks, man. And then they drove. And about 15 seconds later, I was like, oh, shit, that was totally the wrong direction. Not only that, but it actually is literally half an hour away. So they're going to drive for a half hour, not be able to find it, stop somebody else, and he's going to be like, yo, Montana's? You're at the wrong end of the city. It's about an hour that way. They're going to be like, oh, fuck that college kid. But really, it was just, you know, my Canadian politeness was like, these people need help, I've got to help them, but then I gave them the incorrect answer. I should have just said, sorry, I don't know, but instead I probably ruined their lunch. Truth be told, though, that Montana's isn't that good, and I sent them going further into the downtown core. They probably could have found a better restaurant there. Excuse me? What am I supposed to do about this horse hockey? I guess Lazarus doesn't start with Lazarus's rags. He starts with just the ability to respawn. All right. I don't know if this is going to break the game. It certainly makes this a more interesting run, though. So I'm wondering if we can get the double damage benefit from dying with Lazarus's rags and then coming back and then dying with I thought it wouldn't let me pick it up for a second there. Dying with Lazarus's rags, then coming back twice? I don't really know, but we'll see in a second here. The one thing I do like about Lazarus, and the reason I might consider Lazarus, the other thing that sucks about him before I get into that, is that he has negative luck. I know there's a tinted rock there. We'll get it on the way out, hopefully. But he has negative luck. He's the only character that starts with negative luck, which is shitty. But anyway, if Larry Jr. here drops an HP upgrade, what I will try to do, and I don't know if this is actually going to work, but this is why Lazarus is actually maybe a bit preferable for me to, like, Maggie or something like that. We could kill ourselves after fighting Larry Jr. twice. Hopefully get the benefit of 2 damage bonuses. That's why I'm not sweating taking damage right now. Yeah, the benefit of 2 damage upgrades, synth oil. I guess we just take synth oil. Now I feel bad about that HP that we lost. I mean, taking synth oil is great, but we'll maybe try this on the deal with the devil next then. But if we get a 2 damage bonus from Lazarus's rags, then that is pretty sweet. Please don't push that bomb out of the way. I fucking hate you. Those brown spikes are, like, the worst enemies that you can possibly find on the first floor. I don't even know where I would have placed that to do better. I guess I should have placed it at the top. The spikes would have pushed it out to the side. Curse of the Blind. This is terrible. Because it means we have no idea what our item is going to be. If we get a deal with the devil, it doesn't really matter. Because we're going to take whatever they give us. And we're going to be relatively okay with it. And again, if we die, we come back with Lazarus's rags anyway. And we can be, we can probably have, like, I don't know. Oh, that luck upgrade is huge. We can probably have, like, you know, 25%, 30% certainty that we're going to get an HP upgrade from the boss, which sounds bad and is not a guarantee, of course, but, you know, it's the most confident you can be. You know, if you're fighting a boss and you get a boss item and you're not fighting Famine, the odds are very good that you're going to be getting an HP upgrade. I don't know, though. We're in a very weird situation here to begin with. I hate this room as well. You'll have to excuse the sirens. It's New Year's Day. People are going to be a little silly.
Sorry.
What happened, Caden?
It's all closed.
Everything's closed? The grocery store?
Everything. I went to both.
Oh, no.
I went to everywhere.
What are we going to eat today?
I don't know.
We're going to starve to death.
Nothing is open.
Oh, no. Surely there's got to be like a, you know, Chinese food or something open.
Nothing.
Nothing. Oh, geez.
I
well.
Know a yoga place
was open. What am I not going to do yoga today? I got work to do. What am I supposed to do? I got to get nutrition. All I got is like a jar of peanuts.
I want an egg salad sandwich.
I'm actually glad you couldn't get an egg salad sandwich. The stench of an egg salad sandwich is not something I enjoy.
Get out of here.
Well, I'm here. You get out of here. There's nowhere else to go. It's all right. We'll sort it out after this video, Kate. I'm not promising you egg salad, but some kind of nutritional food stuff. I hope you don't starve to death either. That'd be really. It would reflect poorly on me, considering you know we live in a you know fairly developed nation. People would probably be thinking that it was a cover up for a spousal murder or something like that. I'll do my best, Kate. I'm Lazarus, though, so don't get your hopes up. All right, let's do this. This is the longest second floor I've seen in my entire life. I am very much hoping that we get maybe a Hierophant tarot card from this gentleman right here. You know what? Bob's Rotten Head wouldn't be the worst thing in the world. We have zero bombs. This is like one of the very, very few situations in which Bob's Rotten Head showing up would be okay for me, but maybe a Joker card. Or a Two of Hearts. You know, I'll just pop that right away. That'll be fine, too. We're back to full HP. I would love to have an Eternal Heart. Or, sorry, a Spirit Heart to go along with it, but that's okay. Let's move along, shall we? Very, very dense first floor here. Second floor, I should say. Huge rooms. We're going to be like 8 minutes deep by the time we get out. That's the other reason that I dislike Lazarus, is that he's slow. Normally, it depends on the items you get. That synth oil pick up pretty early on is big. What was I doing there? My brain lost the ability to parse how to do this. What do you got for me? Book of Shadows. Oh, that's actually pretty solid. Down. Don't take damage on the back half of this room. Just get to the boss fight. Yeah, and if I can get to the boss... Ooh, if I can get to the boss fight with Book of Shadows, that means we don't need to buy a Spirit Heart from our shop, because I'll have Book of Shadows, which is actually a very decent spacebar item in its own right. Double Monstro. Well, I never, except for all of the times that we have. That being said, fighting Double Monstro means that I am gonna have to be a little bit more vigilant about not taking damage. Neither of these fine young gentlemen here are gonna die before my invincibility wears off, and my invincibility wore off like 20 seconds ago. Please, one of you. Should really just, yeah, there we go. Focus on taking care of one. This deal with the devil is extremely important. We won't be able to see what our boss item is. Oh, that was so close. But I actually will totally kill myself on the deal with the devil to pick up any items that's necessary. We actually can't kill ourselves in these. Oh, yes, we can. Okay, so we'll take this one first. Not that it matters. Ghost baby, so bad. The nail. Not very good. Maybe better than Book of Shadows, though. Actually, you know what? I should have. I think I'm going to take the nail for the extra HP. But I actually like want to get myself killed again. So we can respawn, and I'll see if I get the double damage bonus here. Thank you. Please bring me back. All right. I mean, I don't know if our shots actually do that much more damage. You can't really rely on the stat screen, unfortunately. We got Roid Rage, which is not what I was looking for. We'll pop this, and 48-hour energy. Oh my god, that's kind of beautiful, actually. And now we're gonna go. It's been a very weird start to this run. Not necessarily bad. Probably we... In my opinion, I think we got the worst one-heart deal with the devil item and the worst two-heart deal with the devil item. But even the worst two-heart deal with the devil item is still pretty good. It's all good, Tomo, buddy. Don't even sweat it, dog. We're gonna be fine. Damage is pretty good thus far. If we can get the money to go to the shop, that would be awesome. Save this stars card for maybe getting out of a curse room or something. Big fan is a really good item, in my opinion. Can use it to get up close and personal on these enemies. Not these enemies, but, you know, these enemies in general. I mean, and do a lot of damage with the rotations. And Hey, get out of here. We're moving, like, really, really quickly now. I'm actually starting to think that maybe we might be able to consider boss rush, which is admittedly why I'm... Oh, that was really dumb of me. Admittedly why I'm, you know, keeping the stars card and kind of guarding it. Oh, man, that's a little ridiculous now. Is because we could get that free boss rush item, which, you know, as Lazarus, as any character, but as Lazarus in particular, if you don't like Lazarus, it's a nice help to be able to snag one free item. Come over here quickly, and Big Fan's not quite doing as much damage as I would have hoped, but it is still helpful if you're able to control it reasonably well, you know, get in there, get out. Not the easiest thing in the world, but it's not rocket science either. Alright. Don't meow at me, Tomo. I'm the one who has to go all day without delicious foodstuffs thanks to this holiday. I actually, of all the holidays to be cynical about, I'm not cynical about New Year's at all. New Year's Eve, I'm kind of cynical about. You know, there's a lot of, you know, let's have an excuse to go out and get crazy drunk. Not that I'm like, hey, you don't need an excuse, you just need not to work in the morning, I guess, or something like that. But anyway, I you know, I appreciate the symbolism of the new year, you know, renewal and... You know, you're your best version of yourself. Well, maybe not on January 1st because a lot of people are hungover, but on January 2nd, you're the best version of yourself that you can possibly be, and I think that's something to celebrate. You know, everybody worried about stuff like self-improvement and stuff like that. You know, everyone cares about their family more and feels a little bit more sentimental about stuff. I think that's a positive thing. I'm glad to have gotten meat here, but admittedly, I am a little bit disappointed to have not gotten... a deal with the devil, especially after we sacrificed so much to get that deal with the devil earlier. But I'm actually pretty pleased with the loadout that we have going on here. Keys are a little bit precious still, so I'm not gonna go to the shop until we get a little bit more money. I would like to be able to buy something that makes the nail better. I think that's fairly obvious. If we could end up... Ooh, I like having like a nail charge here, but I'll just use my bombs instead. The nail, you can either use it to crush stuff, or you can use it as a damage bonus. Or both, I guess, but it can be a little cumbersome. We are gonna come down here. It was worth it, I guess. Yeah, well, why not? That gives us enough money to make our shop worthwhile. Anyway, if there's any holiday I'm cynical about, it's Halloween. I just don't get it. I don't like candy that much. I'm not trying to say, oh, let's ban Halloween. Whenever people are like, hey, come to my Halloween party, I'm like, I don't know. I gotta spend like $70 on a costume I'm only gonna wear once. I'm gonna look like a freaking idiot in it. I don't get it. Even when I was young, you know, I was never truly young, I guess, because by the time I was like 9, I asked my parents, I bartered with them, and I was like, how about I never go trick-or-treating again, because I don't like it, but you guys buy me like a CD instead. And they're like, you know what, that's a pretty sweet deal, because we don't want to go out trick-or-treating either. Or maybe they did, and they just put on a happy face, because I know that's, you know, sometimes going out trick-or-treating with a young kid is more for the parents than for the kid. Yeah, I'll take it. I know we could have gotten... we could have gotten 2 spirit hearts out of this room, actually, with the spirit heart and the charge, but that's okay. But yeah, if I were a parent, I would think that is a pretty sweet deal, because I was like, alright, I can just stay at home and spend like $20 instead and just like actually enjoy myself instead of going out in the cold and getting all these like candied apples and stuff like that that might have razor blades in them. Anyway, and again, if you like Halloween, I'm not trying to hate on you or anything like that. You know, it takes all kinds. I'm very happy that you found a holiday that you enjoy. That being said, it's not my scene. I do like horror movies, though. Like, one of the best Halloweens I've ever had is, like, a friend of mine were like, well, this is bullshit. You know, we're not paying, like, what am I... I'm all out of bald costumes, you know? I've already been Jean-Luc Picard, I've been Stone Cold Steve Austin, been Lex Luthor. There's nowhere else for me to go. We need more, like, bald figures in the media for me to be able to... Or maybe I could just get one costume and do the same thing every year. But anyway, we were like, you know, I'm not paying like $30 for a costume or something like that. I'm only going to wear it once. Let's just watch like old horror movies. That was awesome. If you haven't seen Suspiria, it's a Dario Argento like Italian 1970s horror movie, which contains some of the most graphically unsettling, not gory, just graphically unsettling kind of material I've ever seen in a horror movie. It's a thrill ride, a high-octane thrill ride for the 21st century lifestyle, even though it was made in the 20th century. I would very much recommend it if you have... It's not torture porn, you know, it's not hostile, but there's some disturbing imagery in it that's fairly disgusting. And that's sweet. If you could just... Thank you. You know that, like, there's two times... Oh, Curse of the Maze. There's two times when I start talking about non-Isaac-related things in Isaac-related episodes. One of those is when I'm so strong that it doesn't matter, I don't need to focus on the game to win. The other one, which is the one that we're in right now, is when it takes us 45 minutes to get through each room, so I find myself, you know, with a wandering mind. But truth be told, this run is not going badly, it's just not superb right now. We have a collection of items which, if we play well, could probably guarantee us victory. And if we play poorly, we'll probably not guarantee us victory, which is kind of the way I like it. Leech is, again, an acceptable item, at best. I don't think that'll create a bridge, but I did find the secret room, where we got three bombs. It's like my least favorite kind of secret room. If I wanted more bombs, I wouldn't be wasting bombs to come into the secret room, you know? I would just be... Wow, that's a waste of a room, sort of. I would just be doing it. I would just be holding on to my bombs. I don't need your handouts, man. My dad's not a phone. Okay, so we're up to 6 cents, which is not quite enough to have... Oh my god. Not quite enough to have a lot of hope of getting anything done in our shop, but that's okay. I do like having the map here, because having the... Oh, where do we... Oh, Leech probably gave us that HP. I do like having the map here, because the map gives me kind of some reasonable and realistic expectations of how many spirit arts I can expect to gain on any given floor. I'm so bad at fighting Larry Jr. with an orbital, because it's so obvious what I need to not do to do better, but I can't control myself, man. I always end up trying to use my orbital to deal damage, and it's just a silly decision. I don't think boss rush is happening on this run, so let's just accept that, and the sooner you accept that, the more diligence you play with in the future, and you play with more diligence in the future, it's a good thing, all things considered. I know a lot of people are going to say you should be using the nail to crush those mushrooms, but I just can't bring myself to do it, because I know that, like, one in every four of them is going to give me an explosion, which is going to hurt. We can't crush it and get away from it in time. It's just not possible, because we have to be right there to crush it. If we had a holy mantle or something like that, I'd be all over it. And our luck stat should be, like, zero now, so our odds of getting, like, magic mushroom are not great, but they're at least existent. Yeah, so what I'm thinking for this floor is this is going to be the floor where we start trying to make some big plays happen. So we're going to use that IV bag as much as possible to get some extra money. Placenta has been, Leech has been very good at generating that for us. We're going to fight our boss first just because we're ready for it. I'm not going to pick up Purple Heart because it's kind of bad in this situation, I think. It might be like Champion's Belt minus the damage upgrade, which might give us more consumables. I'm still not sure how that works on hard mode. If the champions that are generated as a result of like Purple Heart and Champion's Belt are more likely to pay out with consumables. I did lose a lot of HP on this floor. More HP than I should be, you know, comfortable with, but hey, here we are. What do you got for me? Deal with the Devil? Yeah, Super Bandage is a great item, and our Deal with the Devil is Red Chests, which paid out with a ton of spirit hearts, enough to take us to the HP cap, plus a luck upgrade, plus a telepills, which has cost us our stars card. Yeah, bad telepills, but that's okay. We made big bank here. We can also go to our boss trap room. Remember when you could play IV bag twice on the same heart? Those were the days, man. Those were the days. So we're gonna check out our boss trap room quickly. Where's our shop anyway? It's over there. Boss trap room has one regular chest with a single key in it. Typically, would probably consider that not worth our time. For a bad deal with the devil, that was actually a pretty good deal with the devil. We got like 4 spirit hearts and a luck upgrade. We lost our stars card, but basically that's a loss of a key because we weren't going to be going to boss rush anyway, so... This run is, it's a quiet run, you know, this is not Brimstone Mom's Knife, this is not, you know, Death's Touch, Tammy's Head, or anything along those lines. What this is just, you know, stacking up some decent damage, and if we play smart, we can stay at or near the HP cap. If we don't play smart, we'll still have a semi-realistic chance of success, I think, just by virtue of the fact that we do have the nail, and it would be very awesome if we did not fight Greed in our upcoming shop, and instead... well, if we fought Greed in our next shop, we would probably be able to get items in our next 2 shops. But I would love to just get, you know, 9-volt Nun's Habit early or something like that. Who knows, though? Maybe we could just be better off getting, Sharp Plug? Oh, that doesn't really fit the economy of the nail, I think. Economy of nail! I like that. Anyway. Is your economics lesson It's nonsense. Ladder? We gotta go Humbling Bundle. For sure. More consumable drops? It's not quite... I'll just take it. It's not quite like getting a 9-volt or a battery or something like that. Not that the battery works the same way it did in vanilla. But if we get like two batteries or two charges that drop at the same time, that's a huge get for us. So I'll be extremely thankful for that. Well, that's one way to handle the start of this floor. Lots of seemingly empty rooms. I love blowing up skulls. They're my favorite special rocks to blow up. The negatives of the skulls are like... That's another luck upgrade, yeah. The negatives of the skulls are not non-existent, you know. You can sometimes get hit by hosts or be unable to leave a room because you gotta kill the host that you spawn before killing all the enemies. That's a little tedious, but it's much better than the womb where you get, you know, those bullets that come after you. And it's much, much better than the mushrooms where the poisonous cloud just gets you right away. So I would always, I would love it if skulls spawned on every single floor. It's gonna be hard for bombs, but the fact that we have the nail means we should be able to crack a lot open. Who knows, maybe we get, that's not so good, but we never have to take it again. Who knows, maybe we get, a dry baby or something like that. Or maybe we get a Joker card that gives us a very offensive deal with the devil that we wouldn't have otherwise had. I thought that was my creep. Okay, you're not supposed to take this much damage against these guys. I'll tell you that much. Please stay away. Okay, okay, okay. You know what? Get rid of that creep as soon as possible. We got enough speed that this room should be easy-ish. We're gonna have to come back that way, almost certainly, but honestly, that room is not so bad. The room that I now hate is the room with those four turrets that shoot in the same direction, and then you have the spikes that go up and down at the same time. That is my new least favorite room, but I saw on Reddit there was a solution to solving that room reliably, and I'm gonna try to take advantage of that the next time I see it. It involves stopping in the middle, something I had never considered before. So we'll use the nail here for the damage bonus. A little disappointed that there's not very many skulls, but oh, there was a tinted rock I totally did not even notice there. And we have the keys necessary to be totally okay with that. Okay. It's like the dodging is not working too well. I think we have one more Wallmaster. Hopefully not two. Hopefully not even one anymore. Oh, we do still have one. Okay. I'm going to take Bob's brain. I still kind of like it, even though it sometimes totally screws me. Daddy Longlegs, great item as well. This has been an okay floor thus far. Don't love that. I'm going to every single room because, of course we're going to every single room. Every room that we go to is 1/6 of a spirit heart, and I've been losing enough that, you know, I would like to get more. Wish I could get that. I didn't buy the ladder, though. Joke's on me, I guess. Still, this is going very well. Boom. Boom, and we're through. We were probably fast enough to just run through it anyway, but... Why not give ourselves the best possible chance of success? Right, right. Bob's brain's ready. Almost incredibly dumb damage there. Humbling Bundle, without a doubt, has paid for itself already. It takes about, you know, two payouts for Humbling Bundle to actually give you 15 cents worth of items, so I appreciate it. Ah, here we go. So it paid for itself to come in here. I want to keep the nail, but I'm very happy to have gotten one of the guppy items. Helps out a lot. Thank you, Daddy Longlegs, for making me not have to use Bob's brain there. I think we are starting to come through in the clutch here with some really good kind of like... Not synergies, really, because everything on this run is like working independent of all the other elements, but just like a really good combination of items. They all do their own thing, but they're helping out. Thought I would see maybe if there was a black market there with that bomb. Might as well use the nail right away. Nothing to crush here, but that's alright. We're doing fine on bombs anyway. That is a shop. We don't have enough money for it yet, but presumably... Oh! Alright, that's fine. Presumably, if we find a secret room, it might be possible with Humbling Bundle, but it doesn't matter because we're fighting greed anyway. And when Bob's brain comes back, greed is screwed. Daddy Longlegs might just finish the job himself. I appreciate it. Alright. So this is good again. I think we should look for a secret room. It's not going to be there. I don't want to go back too far. This is turning into like a vanilla run where it takes like an hour to beat the game, which is not bad. You know, we got to do our due diligence to get the best possible win. And I actually am having a lot of fun on this run because it's a little bit strange. Mostly because we got Lazarus's Rags right off the bat. What's up with that? But I think we could afford to push it a little, you know, salt and pepper style here. Salt and pepper style. Not salt and pepper. Salt and pepper. Not to be confused. Yeah, alright. That was well worth it. Arguably one of the best trinkets in the game. You, for a lot of runs, probably the best trinket in the game. If you're mostly concerned about dealing damage. We've got so many things that like work independently of my own tiers. I love it. Bob's Brain works semi-independently of our own tiers. Leech doing some damage over time there without me even paying attention to it. This little Steven show up is ridiculous, but down to the next floor, I guess. And Daddy Longlegs, of course, as well. So I think the best upgrade for me from a utility standpoint would be the ability to fly. If I could just get the ability to fly... sure, that's pretty good. If I could just get the ability to fly, I would be so happy, because I could just hang out, like, on the other side of the map, occasionally firing shots or using, Bob's Brain as effectively as possible. Daddy Longlegs would mostly do all the damage, along with Leech, and I would be mostly safe. Mostly. We are at the HP cap, so I'm not sure why I was so nervous about our HP. I didn't realize that we're actually in a pretty good position here. Nail is ready for the next room. Yeah, there's some skulls here. I don't feel bad about this, then. Might even be some tinted rocks. The thing about the nail is that I end up getting more tinted rocks. Where did that spirit art come from? Maybe a tinted rock. I end up getting more tinted rocks, not because I'm looking for them, but because I'm not looking for them. I just crush them instead. I did take a little damage on that room. This is, like, your ideal nail room. I hate that I took damage here. I always do, though. These fucking fires are so tedious. Now, normally, I would probably just wait for a nail charge to be ready, but instead... I'm gonna throw in some bombs here. And it's like, four skulls for one bomb is a really good trade. I want tarot cards, we're getting black hearts instead, which is not bad! But I want the tarot cards, the moon. The moon is fine, the hanged man is... not super worthwhile. And a second moon card, so we might as well pop one. We got some consumables back. I kind of want to... I know we're using all of our bombs here, but we don't need tinted rocks. What do we get out of that magic mushroom? Mini mush. Ugh, so close. Telepills. Sure. I'll stick with telepills for now. Well, when we get a nail, we can get another nail charge here just by using it on this room. That's probably worth more than the damage bonus that we normally use it for, so... Why not? Side of our shop. Two half-price items because we did get the Steam sale. Yeah, let's see what they are, at least. Converter. I don't like Converter that much, actually. I kind of prefer to have, the Spirit Hearts. Dead Bird. Not very good. But not too bad. So if you're wondering why I'm not getting the battery or not buying the Spirit Heart or anything like that, like, there's no point. We're at the HP cap. But also, we were so close to getting a charge ourselves. And it doesn't really matter. I'll throw a bomb down here. Since we've already been to our shop and our item room, I kind of think we should just go. Like, we should just fight our... That was not very smart. We should just fight our boss. What's holding us back? I guess the idea that we could find a curse room or something like that. So, maybe we'll take this opportunity to seek out... So bad. Take this opportunity to seek out the dead ends. Just to see if there's a curse room. If there is, sweet. If there's not, who cares? And that'll involve going back here one more room, and yes, I'll do this. We could just use two bombs to get that other battery charge. Oh, it might have been worth it! Purity rune. I mean, the purity rune is okay. The best thing we can probably do with it, unless we get a better card... So that's a mob trap room, which we can't take advantage of because we already bunged it up a little bit. The best thing we can do with it is save it as, like, a spirit heart to use later. My thinking there is, because if we get a curse that we don't like on a future floor, we can just pop it. Or we can use it later on this floor to get rid of our deal with, or our curse of blindness for the deal with the devil. Could have bought one more spirit heart, but I kind of don't really worry too much about that right now. Good. Bob's brain's gone. I took some damage. Almost took a little bit more there. I mean, it wasn't good that I took damage, but it's good that Bob's brain is gone. Now it's back, so be ready. It's hard to get rid of a Bob's brain on a red mom fight. You gotta mess up your timing a little bit, but it's going just fine. Probably no tinted rocks in here. Now just kill Mom before Bob's... Hey, we did it. Okay. So we did get a deal with the devil. I will take this, and we'll take the Polaroid just to make our life easier and maybe get more items. We will use the Degas rune here just to see what we've got. That's supposed to get rid of our curse. Well, headless baby, pretty good. Sister Maggie, not very good. Rotten baby, very good. I'm content with this. I think for 3 hearts, we got a pretty good package deal. If I could swap out Sister Maggie for, you know, anything else, that would be great. Oh well, though. HP's still good. Very tricky there. I kind of didn't even want to come into this room, but I will. And if we end up getting some good payouts on it, that's the only thing that matters. You know, get some more nail charges. We're not crazy strong, but what I'll be hoping for, and I say this every time, but I'm really hoping for a good deal with the devil here. We've had some okay deals with the devil. It's probably fair to say that without the nail, this run wouldn't have gone nearly as well. I certainly wouldn't have been nearly as aggressive about taking deals with the devil. Oh, I thought you were deceased. That's my bad. You are deceased now. Okay, red chests. Yeah, we'll try. All right. It's the kind of item that can be great, but is it better than the nail in our current situation? Maybe, actually. The nail, you know, it's a bit more of a conventional item. You know, it's got a lot of roots in greatness in vanilla. But without 9 volts, trickle charge, anything along those lines, I think we might be better off rolling with Tammy's head, honestly, depending on how much damage Tammy's head does, which it doesn't seem like it's a lot right now. But it can simplify these rooms a little bit. This might kill us, but it might be awesome as well. It helps, at least. And all it needs to do is save us 1 spirit heart worth of damage every 6 rooms to be equivalent to the nail. The nail gives us a damage bonus, but it's not that important. This is not our boss fight, unfortunately. Plus, the other thing is the nail is always the nail. Tammy's head, if we get some certain item drops, can be incredible for us. Plus, it's just a little bit more fun, I think. Like, if we get Death's Touch or something here, that would be awesome. I'm not sure if Mom's Knife works very well with Tammy's head, but if it does, we got it, you know? What am I thinking on that one? That was just terrible. So, with 1 Guppy item, I'm not loving the idea. Can't believe I didn't get hit there, but I'm not loving the idea of going to our curse room. So, I'm not going to do it unless we get some more spirit hearts. Ah, that could be potentially a secret room into the curse room, though. No. But this could be if we go back down here. No. Okay. Well, we tried, sort of. More bad damage. If we want to, we can always go back to the nail at the end of the floor. I don't want to. I would really love to stick with Tammy's head, but the thing is, if we were relying on, like, 1 spirit heart from the nail to save our run, we're probably gonna lose anyway. Dark bomb, man. What about it? It could be so good right now. Good. Just the things that I've been making mistakes with. Pay attention to enemy creep. Pay attention to Bob's brain when it comes back. That's about it. Look for tinted rocks, which I did but didn't find any. Alright, without being able to fly... this room is very tricky, in my opinion. This is not helping. I'm throwing a little bit here. Bob's brain, come back! The creep is so annoying. Good. Good. Okay, deal with the devil. No, but Halo. Oh, it makes Tammy's head a little bit better. I don't think the nail is our game-winning item here. I think Tammy's head could be a game-winning item if we make it down to the chest. So let's try. I'm not surprised, by the way, that we didn't get a deal with the devil. Let's be honest, we didn't really earn one. Well, I mean, literally we did, but I didn't play well enough that I feel like I got ripped off. This demon judgment, important part of my my overall plan here. We'll also probably play the crap out of the key beggar.
I have saved us.
What have you found some food, Kate?
Our favorite sushi restaurant is open.
Oh yeah, like our favorite.
Favorite.
Oh.
The one that I need to walk a little.
All right, that's awesome.
Yeah, so I put order of the lunch sushi called
I appreciate that a lot. Thank you.
Now I need to go again.
Brace yourself against the Arctic winds. I played this regular judgment, and the motherfucker paid out. Oh, he killed himself. Paid out with Butterbean. What am I supposed to do about that? Nothing, I guess, is the answer. Oh, you're gonna blow up the demon judgment, you. Oh, it's all coming crashing down. This is not very good. I guess we should blow up those blood banks. Could you, like, every single one of those beggars basically paid out with some kind of way to destroy themselves. I hate that. I hate that a lot. This run isn't sunk yet, though. You know, positive attitude goes a long way in Isaac. Keep your morale high. And then just do your best to stick with it. Not every run can be won this early. But just because it's not like a one run doesn't mean it's a lost run. Thank God. And if we ever get despawned, let's just remember, at least it's not a run where we're playing as the lost. Okay. Let's be honest. That was bad damage. I'm tilting a little bit. If we're gonna come back from this, the most important thing is that we just don't tilt. That Gimpy pickup is pretty big, actually, especially for free. All we need to do is survive until the chest. You survive until the chest. Life's good. Great Bob's Brain play there. Could just leave the room, but, you know, better to try to get some consumables out of it. Thank you, Daddy Longlegs and Tammy's Head. Stay away from me. Thank you. Hanged Man. Pretty good for allowing me to leave this room without taking damage, but... Good. Flies are helpful. Tammy's Head's helpful. Daddy Longlegs helpful. We're just gonna leave and then we're gonna come back to get that chest. Remember, these guys create creeps, so... Stay far away. Okay. Again, the Dark Bomb pickup would have been out of control. Where's my Bob's Brain play? There's my Bob's Brain play. It keeps missing, though. Good. I appreciate that. That was the greatest Gertie Jr. play of all time. I can't even hate on that one. Basically rushed me down just in time for Bob's Brain to explode. Makes him a total dick, but hey, got the job done, didn't he? Oh, thank you. Thank you, Dead Bird. You got me a battery. It's a shame I don't still have the nail, but I made my bed, now it's time to lie in it, and I think it's actually working out okay. Come on, DDL. Daddy Longlegs. Oh, that turret is not dead. Makes my life a lot harder. Okay, there we go. Leech is going to do some serious damage. Rotten Baby's going to help. Bob's Brain, just sneak that Bob's Brain in there. Good job. And this is a very easy Mom's Heart fight, actually. I'd say we got pretty lucky there. And we're going up. I'll probably pop the world card, because this is the most delicate part of this whole situation. If we don't get good items on the chest, we're probably fucked. Alright. If we don't get good items on the chest, we're probably fucked, but at the same time, we gotta give ourselves the best chance possible to get there, of course. Stop moving, please. This could be great. If you give me, like, an Emperor Tarot card... Or, Perthrow Rune is actually very solid if we make it to the chest. This just gives me more incentive to make it to the chest. Oh, come on with the bullshit blowing up the bomb fly. Right as it got in my face. At least we're getting so many red heart drops. So, unless I get hit, like, three times on one room, we should be fine to keep ourselves at least at 3 HP. So then we've got to beat Isaac with 3 HP. It's very doable. Much like Yamada. Every time I make a joke in a Bostonian accent, I don't know why, but I really want to... I have, like, Good Vibrations by Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch playing in my head. It really adds a nice little, like, coda to every Your Mother joke. You should try it sometimes. Empress. It's pretty good. I'm impressed with that. We'll use that to fight Isaac, and then we'll come back for this Perthrow rune. Hopefully, that doesn't mean that I'm gonna walk on some spikes like a GD idiot. Money's getting a little out of control. I probably don't need this much. It would be sweet, though. Let's put a bomb down here, see if the secret room is over here. I was hoping we'd be able to get into that curse room for free. Can't always get what you want. Easy enough. What do you think about this, like, secret room situation over here? You like it? You hate it? Can't believe that sort of worked out. I think that I sort of hate it, to be honest with you. I'll probably just fight the boss instead of getting funky with weird stuff down there. Getting funky with weird stuff is the name of my first album, but that doesn't mean I support it. Good, that'll give us permanent Polaroid invincibility. We definitely do not want Ringworm. Well, we don't want it to replace cancer, at least. That was a good use of that. This is fine. It would also be great to find a secret room here. Oh, okay, okay, okay. Explosive diarrhea, huh? Well, if we live, this will be good. This is a big moment for us. This is the hardest room we've had over the course of this fight, probably. Even though I shit-talk Isaac for being too easy all the time. It's incredibly important that we play our cards right here. Rotten baby flies. I don't even need to hit my own tears that much. I just need to not get hit. You know that Xbox One ad slash the dialogue from 1977's Best Picture winner Rocky? It ain't about how hard you get hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep coming. That's what basically we're doing, except the opposite, because we can't get hit very hard at all. But we don't hit that hard either, but we kind of hit like a lot. We're like a really fast, like, jabber or something like that. You can tell that I don't watch very much boxing, I guess. I did play Fight Night round 4, though. Well, this was a very easy fight, and really, it's getting down to the chest makes this Tammy's Head pickup so much more valuable, in my opinion. If we get down to the chest, which we did, then I really feel like we're in a good position. And in fact, what I may actually do now, because we have that second secret room open, is check out this room. And this is fine. We'll get hit a couple of times to come in here. And my hope was that we would get an item, of course. We didn't. That's okay, though. And now just don't fuck it up by walking over some spikes like a total idiot. And you should be fine to get back to full HP, or at least like the closest half-heart analog. Good. This has not been an easy run, but it is a testament to the perseverance that you can have. And it's been kind of a zany run, which I appreciate. Curse of the Lost. Whatever. Hourglass. Death's Touch. This is exactly what I asked for when I got Tammy's Head. That's the mind? We finally got the mind! I know all. I don't know what that does for us, but we got it. And Polyphemus, holy shit. Well, there's probably a better room to use Perthro on, but why don't we just try it? And we got Mom's Wig out of it. This is one of the greatest chests I could possibly imagine. I don't know what the mind does, but I do know that this Tammy's Head pickup feels a lot less stupid now. I know that you can come out of the woodwork. I know there were some people going, oh, you got rid of the nail? GG. Well, you would have been GG if you didn't get carried on the chest. Well, that's what happens when you go all in. If you lose, you lose. If you win, you win. Lucky me. All right. It's amazing how shaky this run was looking on the Womb 2 and how not very shaky at all it's looking right now. Do we have Placenta? Is that how we keep getting this HP? I thought that was my bomb fly for a second there. I got freaked out. So at the very least, we picked up the Mind. That's going to give us one more item, one closer to getting a Platinum God. Real or otherwise. And I don't think we're dying on this one. I'll take it, just because I think it'll be very weird. You know what I noticed as well on this run? We didn't fight Krampus at all. That doesn't happen all that often. I think my reflection with Tammy's Head might actually be terrible, but in a good way sometimes. Like, I think it's terrible for enemies that are far away, but if the enemies end up being close, they get hit by more bullets. And we can kind of, like, swing it around here a little bit, as you can see. As long as we play with some purpose. So that's, like, three of them dead. Our shots are pretty huge as well. If only we had Lump of Coal. That's why I said, like, we didn't fight Krampus. It dawned on me when I realized how awesome it would be to have Lump of Coal tears right now. You should be, like, straight up dead. I can't believe I didn't even put you in the other phase. And with Penetrative Tears, my reflection's actually pretty sweet because the shots hit on the way in and then they hit on the way back. Yeah. We gotta just, if we have like some momentum when we use this, it works a little bit better. Daddy Longlegs helping out, Bob's Brain helping out. Every one of these guys is gonna get killed in one hit, I think. There's just a lot of things to hit. Oh, take you. Mom's Eye is not a good pickup, by the way, but it is what it is. We got it. More keys that are unnecessary. I'm very sorry about this, Gurglings. The Hermits. Oh, double cage room. This is where we figure out if this is actually worth its salt. Because double cage room is pretty annoying. Yeah, you know what? This run is very, very good now. A double cage room was not very much of a threat in the least. Come down here, and you're not always going to get as lucky as I got, but man, that feels good. Let's fight Blue Baby. This is a bad day to be you, I'd have to guess. It really only did like one third of the HP right off the bat, but it's still, like, Tammy's head in this situation is like having Krampus's head on every room, which is pretty nice. Even if it doesn't kill enemies, it's going to do quite a number on them. Mom's Wig helping, Leech helping, Daddy Longlegs, GG! Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, click the like button, helps out a great deal, and of course subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Wait, let's look at our stats screen. 339, baby. We need Meat Boy, level 4, and D100. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.